Mike LaMarca, you pitched a story with all the turmoil, Ebola, enterovirus. You're chasing zombies. What do you got?
Bill, the afternoon was gloomy and dark as the boys and the ghouls came to Asbury Park. The zombies did gather and rise from their graves. I decided to join in their black parade. The boardwalk was covered with hordes of undead, and I felt in my stomach a feeling of dread. I saw corpses and monsters with fangs and with claws, but they hobbled and limped for a really good cause. You see, zombies eat brains in the day and the night, so they raise lots of cash to continue the fight against cancerous tumors that are found in your head. Because brain cancer tastes bad if you ask the undead. Thousands of zombies arrived on the scene, but the crowd was just smaller than in 2013. Oh, and all the event brought me ghoulish delight. Happy walking to all, and to all a good fright.
I got nothing. That's awesome. Jillian, you were there.
I was there.
Tell me about it.
Okay, wait, hold on. I got a seg one. It was gorgeous. It might have poured all the beginning of the day, but when we got there, it was gorgeous. And people go all out. Like, there were some people that, while I was walking and they were passing you, you were a little freaked out. Like, there was one person in a cage, and they were like, oh.
How did you prep for this? Because that was a lot of work.
The only thing you have to do is put on some form of an attire, then get some red paint, and just literally douse yourself in it. I think that's what majority of people did, because most people are just walking around looking like they're covered in blood. But some people, they are freaky. Like, some people go above and beyond, bigger than Christmas and Halloween. I mean, they went all out, and they put on a great show.
For some reason, people love zombies.
Right.
So, can't get enough zombies? Check it out. My 9.